Hey, what up? Going on week three, I think, of this day-by-day vlog thing. And today's Tuesday. And if you're wondering by now, why do you always start these things on Tuesday? Like, what happens on Monday? Why is it so secret? Well, secret is, Mondays are really boring. Pretty much never have anything planned on Monday. And as I say that, like 2 weeks from today, there's an event going on at the little theater. So I will have something on a Monday. But normally they're pretty boring. Today, however, Tuesday is the weekly improv jam at the Focus Theater. And I haven't gone in a while, but I'm really hoping to go tonight. But first, we have to get through the day. And finally, the day is over. I don't even want to say what time it is, but suffice to say, I did leave a little bit late because of a brake problem on a Tundra that wasn't even a problem, just Tundra brakes feel weird. I am here at the library to return this book that I've checked out a couple of times trying to like line up the 3 week loan period with my free time. And yeah, in the back there's a link to download the book for free. So yeah, I'm just gonna do that. This week's also the Fireman's Carnival, and around Monday at some point, usually the midway trucks start showing up, all the carnies start unloading and setting up rides. By Tuesday, it's a pretty big sight going on, and it's just kind of weird, like, how the town feels different, like, through the village of Webster, like, there's a lot more going on for, like, one weekend of the year. So, as of Tuesday, got the Ferris wheel up, all the trucks set up, the kiddie area. Looks like most of the rides and such and the food trucks. And then that building there, that unassuming building there with nothing on it, was actually the first McDonald's I ever worked at before we moved down the street, before they transferred me to the other one, and before I just quit altogether. So you can assume that being there when the carnival's there means that it was a weekend of hell every year. So here's something you may or may not know. The arrow next to the fuel pump icon tells you which side of the car your fuel door is on. If there's no arrow, the icon itself will tell you what pump you're looking for. So here the pump is on the right. Well, I need one that's on the right. If it's on the left, you need one that's on the left. But if you are a moron, you look at this gauge in a car you've owned for almost 2 years, and you don't see either, which causes you to forget that it was on the left side, and you're just incredibly confused. And you look like an idiot. Hey, what up? It's Wednesday. Today is technically the start of the carnival, but it's a weird day. It's usually open like 1 to 6 or something like that, mostly for old people and children, so I'm not gonna go to that. And I'm not even gonna go tomorrow because that's the parade. I'm actually gonna avoid that area of the village like the plague. So, what I'm doing instead is I have 2 weeks of vlogs to edit. And a test episode of our podcast. But before we get to all that, packages! Just a few things. I got the fin straightener from Robinair because it turns out that's exactly what the Snap-on truck would have sold me. I also got a trailer brake light tester because it's been sitting in my Amazon wishlist for like a million years. I got a multi SD card reader thing because I can never find one of these or the USB adapter when I actually need it. And after years of telling myself, you need to get a dash cam, I got a dash cam. Highly recommend one of these. They will seriously save you when you are not expecting it. And also, I thought it'd be good for capturing on the road, like time lapse type footage. So we'll see. Well, I got most of the clips organized at least, and I got some of Wednesday started. So that's progress. Keep at it tomorrow. Said I was gonna avoid the village like the plague. But then I got hungry and decided to order from Webster Hots. So I had to drive to the village anyway, which was awful. And I made it even worse because I thought that 250 and Ridge were already going to be closed. And they weren't. So I drove all the way around Assault Road for nothing and wasted 15 minutes. But the cheeseburger is going to be great. So that'll make up for it. And since it's July 11th, or 7-Eleven, if you will, I stopped at our A-plus slash 7-Eleven for a free Slurpee and this neat Snubble Straw. Still down here, editing the first week. I started with Wednesday, assuming it was going to be the hardest one, because there's like 2 hours of footage, just on the road, not even me talking or anything, just passing signs, and it's all going to get cut down to like 30 seconds anyway. But I want it to be a good 30 seconds, so I'm putting a lot of time into it. And it's nearly done. Wednesday is nearly done, and then we can move on. Tomorrow's a new day. All right, it's time. We are on the way to the Fireman's Carnival right now. It's like a 5-minute walk. Any other Friday, I'd be like, okay, sure, I don't care, let's stay out late. But being that I'm covering for the team tomorrow, probably don't want to stay out super late. But it'll be cool. Hit some carnival games, some carnival food, get one of those fresh squeezed like $17 lemonades. It'll be a great time. My buddy Kevin said he was going to show up at some point, but didn't say exactly when. And I'm about to pass his house in like a minute, so I should probably text him and figure out when. There was this thing in Rochester like 20 years ago, and it died off by like the early 2000s, where you just see like a ton of these sponsored painted horses around everywhere, like malls, schools, corporate offices downtown, literally everywhere. And you can still see some of them around today. Maybe I should dig into the history of these a little bit, because I still see some of them around. They're kind of interesting. And now we're entering the belly of the beast. I'm literally steps away from the carnival ground. I'm gonna set a very simple mission for tonight. Part one, get a hot dog. Part two, have a drink. And part three, play that, the game that the firemen always put on where you get a bunch of dimes, you try to throw them into a glass.
Guys usually stops and gets breakfast sandwiches around like 8:30 or so on the way back with the stock order, but told me over till then, got some iced coffee, classic mocha with cream, and then after we're done here, I'm heading back to the carnival. One of the perks of working at a car dealership is basically unlimited access to the detail shop whenever I want, especially with like how close I am to the dollop guys. I gotta say, having a clean car is like the most amazing feeling.
I own an 04 Mitsubishi and an 07 Hyundai. I am no stranger to old cars, but I gotta tell you, they don't feel like 12 and 14 years old. If you take care of a car, it'll take care of you. So if you're looking at trading in your car because like it feels old and worn out, try getting it detailed. It'll feel like a brand new car again. Or if you want the new car features without the monthly payment, go to an aftermarket shop. See if you can get a touchscreen head unit, nav, backup cam, Bluetooth, super cheap. Even heated seats and remote start. That's way cheaper than a car payment. Seriously, try it. Heading back for Carnival Round 2 right now. Judging by this forecast I just looked up and the sky I just looked up at, it's going to rain very soon. But the forecast tells me it'll be over by like 9 o'clock. So, might be there for a couple hours, but I was planning on being there for a couple hours anyway. And today, honestly, all I want is a funnel cake. Funnel cake, not fried dough. There is a difference. And I'm already feeling a little bit of rain. They better have been right about that over by 9 thing. As quick as this all went up, it's coming down even quicker.
12 hours from now, once sunrise hits, there's not going to be a single sign that anything was ever here except for beer cans on the ground being picked up by Boy Scouts.
Funnel cake acquired and properly dressed.